Hi, Kevin Kim with Yamaha Commercial Audio. I thought I'd give you a quick run through on some of the really cool EQs we've got inside our plug-in racks on Rivage PM10. While we know we've got great EQs on board, check out what we've got inside our plugins racks. So here we've got the Rupert EQ 773. This is our virtual circuitry modeling of a classic Rupert EQ from the 70s. Those that grew up on this EQ, they want this EQ on everything all the time, and they have ever since. Now it's available on every channel if you want to use it within this system. So some of the really cool things about this EQ is it's a really aggressive EQ. You've got the transformers like to die for, that's the big thing. And if you use it and you're using a transformer on the input side of this console, on that channel, you're doubling down on transformers. We can come in, we can bypass the filters here, you still get the sound of the transformer. Also notice that we have the assist button here, that what it does, it turns these numbers on and off that are tied to the encoders below and the values at the bottom of the screen here. So again, this is available on every channel if you want to use it. It is a vintage EQ that we captured wonderfully with our VCM technology. If we come over to our other screen, now we're looking at the channel parameter view, in particular we're looking at the inserts and the direct outs. So here we can see what we have in our chain. We can see if we've got a unit bypassed. I'll show you more about that in a moment. But if we come back over to this unit in the middle screen, we have the Rupert EQ 810. Now the 7 series we just took a look at represents basically what Rupert was doing in the 70s, while this unit represents what he was doing in the 80s. People who grew up on this unit, they live and die by this EQ. It stands alone on its, you know, its own merits of sound quality and what it does to a channel. So here we've got individual bypasses for each filter if you want to. We can bypass the entire unit here. Again, we still get the transformer. We've got our drive. We've got a different transformer, so it's got its own sound unto itself. And you have the ability to change whether you're driving a mic transformer or a line transformer. So this EQ, again, people who grew up with this one, they swear by this. So if we come back over to our channel parameter screen here, this Portico device, I loaded it up twice and I'll show you why. Notice, of course, this one's bypassed. If I change the view here and we look at it, we can see here that this one's slightly grayed out. That's a visual indication that we are bypassed. That's one place you can see that it's bypassed. Another cool thing about the insert chains is here we can see it's bypassed with the red circle, and we have 6 different pickoff points or where we can choose our inserts. Maybe you want your first insert after your second insert. So it's a really powerful tool, being able to move your inserts around like this. And then of course you can move your delays and your direct out points as well. So another view is if I come to the overview screen, we can see here in the overview, there's a lot of information. Right there, we can see that red circle again. Just at a glance, we can see that we're bypassed there. So that's just a couple of things to note on ways to look at things here. If we come back over now to that Portico device, here we have another well-respected EQ that represents that era when he was doing the Portico stuff. Again, same team that modeled our emulation of the Rupert transformer at the front end did all these. So they're spot on. Again, we can bypass the whole unit, as you see here. We know we had that on. When you bypass any of these units here, it's like taking it out of the insert chain. So now you're not getting the transformer, you're not getting the filters or whatever the device is doing. So just note that's the difference. As opposed to bypassing here, if you do that, you'll get the warmth of the transformer, you just don't get the filters. This EQ, of course, has, you can turn off the individual filters as well. And of course, we've got assist on each of these. Now, if we come back over one more time and look at our channel parameter screen, we can see another vintage EQ here. This is one of my favorites as well. So we can see it here, but if we look at the pop-up in the middle screen, here we have our EQ 1A. So this has been around. You've seen this maybe in our CL and QL series along with the Portico EQ. One of the really cool things about this EQ, or unique in as well, is that here you can select your frequency. So we can see it down below. You choose your cycles per second or your frequency, and then you can choose to boost and or attenuate that same frequency. And it does it in a way that doesn't cause phasing. It's really cool. I love this unit on kick drum. I know some people will not record a vocal without it. That's great on snare. It's another classic EQ, and of course we can bypass the whole unit here as well and still get the warmth of the unit. So on the surface itself, so this is all on screen stuff, we can, you know, imagine we didn't have one of these guys up on the screen and we were wondering why are we not hearing that unit that we saw was bypassed earlier. We could see maybe it was on, but the insert point was turned off. So there's visual indicators here, and we could even open up a plug-in window right from the surface as well. So there's a quick run through of some vintage pieces within Rivage PM10.